Hello everybody, my name is Walter and today I want to show you how you can build my 4x4 double bolt door with a hidden junction. So as you can see here, this is a simple bolt door which looks the same from each side with some pressure plates. And if I stand on top of those, the whole thing here will open up and I can just walk through. But if I stand in here while it's closing, you can see that another hidden tunnel here opens up, which then I can use to go into my hidden base or whatever. I can also come from this side here and then simply press the button down there and then get out of the door. So that's basically what this thing here does. Now let's talk about the sizes. So as you can see, it's a bit longer than the usual 4x4 bolt doors, since it needed some space to have some crawling space for the player. So the total length here, including the pressure plates, is 9 blocks. The entire thing is 10 blocks wide and 10 blocks high, with the opening in the dead center of it. And that's the sizes. Now let's talk about the required resources. So you're gonna need, of course, some building blocks, then 3 stairs, 2 of which are visible. And at the moment they are more or less hidden, since they look the same as the normal blocks around. So this block and this block here is actually the stairs, or the backside of one. Then, concerning redstone components, it's 47 redstone dust, 9 redstone torches, 6 repeaters, 4 comparators, 5 observers, 42 sticky pistons, 4 pressure plates, and the wooden button. And that's all you're gonna need, so let's show you how to build this door here. Okay, so the first step is marking the center of the door with a couple blocks right at the floor level. Then with a 3 wide gap we need towards the front 2 blocks with pressure plates and the same towards the back. Then we go below the entire thing. First place 2 blocks like so, and a third block there, then a raised block here, then another 3 blocks like this here. Then put 3 redstone dust here, 1 there, a comparator in this direction and another one in this direction there. Then a block here with a repeater on 4 ticks in this direction, running into a block with redstone dust on top there. Then a raised block, lowered block. Then we more or less mirror the entire thing, so the 2 blocks down here. Third block, raised block, 3 blocks. Then the redstone dust here, here and there. The comparators and the repeater on 4 ticks there. Then some more redstone dust on top here. Then we go up with 2 blocks diagonally. Put some redstone dust here, a torch there. Then for now let's actually place a block with a torch here so the entire thing is powered. This will be removed later on. Then add another 4 blocks in a row there and here. Redstone dust on top. Then torches towards the outside, like so. Then a sticky piston in here and on top of the torches. And that's pretty much all of the circuitry for the floor done. So all that's left is actually starting to fill in the entire floor here. And then let's give it a little test run, so let's remove the torch here. And after some time, this whole thing here should come up, and this one here should come down. And that's all that's supposed to happen here. Following that, let's go to the left side here. First, place an upside down stairs on top of this redstone wire in this orientation here. Then let's go and place some sticky pistons next to the torch right here, then towards the front, then towards front and back like so, and then we double this once more like so. Next, grab some observers and place them facing in this direction on top of the double piston extender there. Then we go towards the back here. First we place a block on top of the torch, then we have blocks going up and down towards the front and back there. Then inwards another blocks and a raised block here. Sorry, make that upside down stairs here and here. Again, make sure that it is placed that way around, as you can see here. Next, grab some repeaters and place them on 2 ticks each there. Then redstone dust on top of all these blocks here. Now a full block here to cut off that wire. And with that, this part is more or less done. All that's left is filling in the rest of this wall here. Like so. After that, let's start with the ceiling part. For that, go up a layer here. Then we go up another layer with 2 rows of 4 blocks each, as you can see here. Put once more redstone dust on top. Then steel pistons towards the front and the back. Then once more a lowered block here with some redstone dust on top, and then you can once more fill in the rest of the ceiling with normal blocks. And with that, let's go to the right side. Here we start at the top with a block next to this block with the redstone wire. Then we go down towards front and back. Place a observer facing downwards there. Then we need normal blocks here, followed by normal blocks going diagonally like so. And in between, instead of a normal block, we need another observer facing down like so. Then put a repeater on 2 ticks on top of those observers there. 3 redstone dust here, then 5 here. Then we go below the entire thing and start with a double piston extender here and here. Then below them another one. And then towards the sides just some plain sticky pistons, like so. And then we need to go towards the center here and diagonally to those pistons here. We need a sticky piston there with a block spit out. And once more, the next step is filling in the rest of this wall with normal blocks. And with that, we are almost finished. So now let's remove the power source down here and wait for a moment. And now everything should close up, as you can see here. And if I stand on some of the pressure plates, it should open up again. So that part is working, which means now it's time to start building the tunnel down here. For that, start with a simple 2x1 tunnel. And on the first segment of the tunnel, we need a wooden button. Doesn't matter whether it's at the front or the back, but we need one here, so we can actually open the door from the inside there. And then it's just continuing on this tunnel setup, as you can see right there. And with that, the last part is then filling in the front and the back wall and maybe some of the floor here. And voila! So as you can see, now everything is finished up. I also decided to replace some of the blocks here with quartz to hide the somewhat visible stairs there. And I also added some light sources to keep mobs from spawning. And that's pretty much the end of this little tutorial here. I hope you enjoyed it, and well, see ya!